Oh, it's bad.
Hey guys, how's it going? So today we're back with another Every Room is a Different Blank, and it has been highly requested to do Every Room is a Different Sims 4 World. So we're gonna give that a go. If you guys like the video, please give me a thumbs up. Leave any comments or suggestions you may have in the comment section down below. And some of you may not know, I have started streaming on Twitch as well, so you can find that link in the description. And yeah, let's get into the video. Okay, so I have a random wheel here of all of the worlds in The Sims 4. So I'm gonna go ahead and spin it right off the bat to see where we're gonna be building. Evergreen Harbor. Okay, so we're gonna build here in the Eco Lifestyles Evergreen Harbor today, and how I'm gonna do this for the outside is going to be based around like this world. So basically shipping containers coming in hot. This might actually work in our favor though, because we could do like every shipping container is a different Sims 4 world. So far this is kind of the shell that I'm coming up with. I want it to be obviously very green inside here, so I'm kind of working away on that. Obviously gonna have to use a lot of ladders in this, but we're going 4 stories high here. Slowly getting somewhere with my shell here. I'm kind of just adding the ladders right now, making sure you can get up everywhere you need to go. I'm gonna start adding in some landscaping, and then I'm gonna move outside and start doing some of the eco lifestyle like items, kind of inspired by this trash can to add graffiti on my place. So I'm gonna do that. I love it. Oh yes, I've been adding graffiti a lot lately. I don't know, I feel like it looks kind of cool. So I'm kind of picturing this as like a community, like a whole bunch of different people live here from different worlds, but they've come together in this little home where they all have one thing in common, and it's living an eco lifestyle. I've done my little back area here with the eco lifestyle kind of items, candle making station and the bug boxes. I've got a little garden happening in the back. On the outside, we've got the graffiti covered shipping containers. I don't know, I feel like it adds a really cool aspect that I haven't really done with the shipping containers before. Oh, last thing I wanted to do was add lights hanging from those trees. So I'm gonna do that, and then we can see what we're gonna do for the first shipping container, I guess. So I'm kind of raising up these fairy lights into these trees. Again, not my idea. I've been doing a lot of build tours lately on stream, and I've seen you guys do this, and it looks super, super cool hanging from these trees. I just love that look. I feel like that looks really, really cool. Let's go spin for the first shipping container. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 5 of them. All right, spinning for the first shipping container. What do we get? We get Willow Creek. So in the first room, I think I'm gonna do maybe a living room. I haven't really decided how many people are gonna live here yet, so we'll try and do living room, study maybe in the first room. Then maybe over here we'll do like kitchen and dining. I'm gonna make this a bedroom because I just kind of made a private little entrance there. So this will be a bedroom, and maybe this will be a bedroom as well. 2 bedrooms. I don't know what I'm gonna put in here. We'll figure it out. Willow Creek, we're gonna go the purple flowers. We're gonna go pancakes picture. Got my lighting and my flooring and wallpaper. Might change all of this. We'll see. Look at Aria. She loves that new rug. She loves rolling on it. So I've kind of come to the park to get some inspiration here. This is obviously the Willow Creek famous park here. So trying to see what furniture they use. Obviously, I think this is mostly base game stuff. So gonna keep with that vibe. So they definitely use this yellow bench there. So I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna put a chess table for sure. I know it's not base game, but definitely gonna have to put some of these trees in here. Willow Creek, you think of the purple tree. I feel like I can't get the wallpaper right. First thing that's really bothering me. We definitely need Bob eating his pancakes. He's definitely making an appearance. Maybe we'll put him over here. I also kind of think of like the kids' pirate ship. So I'm gonna stick that in here, like the little like jungle gym they have. Willow Creek also reminds me of like family homes. So I'm kind of going for that. They also use this like base game plant quite a bit. So I'm gonna put that in here. Oh, I wanted to do the pond somehow. How can I make that work? We do have the fountain like outside. So I mean, I guess that kind of makes sense. I'm also gonna put a little fish bowl because like you can go fishing there. Oh, I have to put something for the goths. Maybe I could put a little fountain in the corner. Okay, okay, okay. Maybe I'll put these little candles here as a tribute to the goth mansion. Okay, I'm gonna move on. It's not the cutest for sure. Let's move on and do the kitchen and dining room. What are we going to do for the kitchen and dining? Brightchester. So I'm gonna try and make this look like a grand like dining hall, I think. Discover University is the Brightchester world. So we're gonna try and make this look like a cafeteria kind of thing, I guess. So checking out their kind of like cafeteria here. you're looking at the grounds and it's very academic. Got my little chairs there, and then I think I'm gonna put like some books on the table, maybe some of these. Maybe feeling like that blue there. We're gonna try that. Kitchen's gonna be over here, so I need to get my fridge and all that stuff. Maybe we'll do mini fridge because it's kind of like that's what people use in university. On the walls, we'll put up some of the university posters. What else for in here? I've gone back and forth like a million times. Maybe I'll put this little like bookshelf up here that's fully functional so they can actually read. Brightchester has a lot of libraries, obviously. Some of those up on the wall, and I feel like we're kind of like almost done in here. I'm gonna move on. Might come back to this room. This one was a little tricky, but we've got our kitchen and we've got our dining room. Let's go upstairs. I think it's time to do a bedroom. And we're spinning for a bedroom. What are we gonna get? Strangerville. Yes, yes. Yes, I love Strangerville. You guys know that. One of my favorites. And we're doing a Strangerville bedroom. All right, so first I'm gonna put down my basics. Obviously gonna have to get the Strangerville bed going. Oh, the diagonal rooms are so annoying. Okay, Strangerville bed going over there. Got a picture of the abandoned diner. We're gonna make it kind of messy in here for sure. I'll get the storage going over there, and I have to put these plane parts somehow. If I can fit them, maybe this is like an indication of the plane wreck. Oh God, I don't think I can shrink any of them. That's way too big. I think the only thing I could fit in here is the wing. We'll put some broken down little signs here. That looks kind of cool. Gonna use this for my little end table right there. Strangerville, like I feel like I have definitely made my fair share of like Strangerville bedrooms at this point. I'm gonna use this actually to cover the wall. I like that. Oh yes, lava lamps. I love the lava lamps. I love the look that they add. Get my Strangerville car in there, and then... Oh, if I could fit the Strangerville bar, I can fit it. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna hide the window with it. Oh, it's just the mirrors clipping. No! Maybe in this little corner, it'll just be like a whole bunch of stuff they've kind of collected from Strangerville, like little cluttery items that remind us of it. So we've got these little guys. I think I'm gonna change this to like more of a deserty looking feel. And I'm gonna put some cactus in here too. Like maybe I'll use that instead. And then for the ground, I think I'm gonna change the ground to like sand. That's so inconvenient for a bedroom, but it's Strangerville. I'm gonna like shrink these down and put the cactus in these little things so it looks like they're kind of just growing them on their own. There we go. That looks a little better over on that side. I can put a dresser right here. Gonna take a trip to Strangerville, see what else I'm missing. I feel like there's definitely a little bit. Maybe they'll kind of keep their stuff in these bags to avoid the sand that's happening in their bedroom. Okay, gonna take a trip. Hold on. Okay, I got my cactus. Maybe I'll go and debug and get some tires and stuff. And I want to find some of those signs to kind of put into my build here. And maybe that sign too. Okay, also gonna stick in some of these like weird plants. Maybe I'll just kind of like shrink them down, put them next to this thing here. Like this diner sign kind of reminds me of that one that was in that main Strangerville area. So maybe I'll put that like in between the tires. I'll stick a mirror in there. Again, still have to make get a functional bedroom happen in here. Okay, so I think we're good in here. We've got our mirror over there, tons of weird equipment happening. We've got our diner and our tires for the gas station in Strangerville, our huge bar that's covering the window, probably on purpose, and this one with our weird little knickknacks in there, our broken down sign, and our plane wing. Then on this side, we've got our cactus. We've got a whole bunch of different kinds of cactus, our weird stuff going up the side with our Strangerville plants, and our little bed. So I feel like we nailed it. Feel like we nailed Strangerville. Let's go up. Don't know what we're gonna put in here. Maybe we'll make it depend on what we get. All right, I've updated my wheel. Let's spin the wheel, see what we get for the next room. Glimmerbrook. So we do have like a bookshelf somewhere around here. We have one there and we have one in here, but we don't really have a full like study area. So maybe I'll do that for in here. It'll be like a magical study area. Oh, I wanna include the portal somehow. I wonder if I can find the portal in debug. Hold on. Let's go get some inspiration. Go back to Glimmerbrook. So tons and tons of these really tall trees in Glimmerbrook. Really winding path. Maybe we can make a path kind of in Glimmerbrook. And then back there goes into the magical portal. I'm gonna make a portal. How am I gonna do this? So I feel like Glimmerbrook itself is really quite green and like mysterious and dark. So I'm not gonna add too much lighting in here, I don't think. Switching out the door that I had here also to that one there. So I'm gonna have my little desk area over here. I don't think I'm gonna put a computer. I kind of just want it to be like a little area where they would go and like make potions or something. I think I'm gonna put a shelf above and I'll put my potions up here. Maybe a little like crystal ball. There we go. Maybe instead of like what I had out here, I'll put a little cauldron outside. And then somehow I have to make the portal over here. I don't know how I'm gonna do that. I don't know if I have it in debug at all. I'm gonna do the same thing that I was doing with the flower pots for Strangerville and put an evergreen tree in one of the pots. There we go. Love that. All right, and then need to make my portal somehow. I'm thinking of doing it with like columns or something. I'm trying so hard to make this look even the slightest bit magical. This is my makeshift portal. Oh, it's bad. I don't know. This is my magic portal. I can't. I don't know about this one. What if we did that instead? Does that kind of look like a portal? I feel like that looks a little better than what we had. There we go. This is our portal. Our Glimmerbrook portal. Oh God. Okay, there we go. Beautiful. I feel like the hanging plants kind of look a little magical. I don't know. Glimmerbrook. Oh, she's rough. Okay. Up we go. Final room. What are we gonna get? Spinning the wheel for the final room. Forgotten Hollow. Maybe we can do another bedroom upstairs. Up here, we're gonna do spooky, like, vampire bedroom. I'm realizing right now we don't have a bathroom in this entire place. Oh no. Uh-oh. Oh no. That's not good. I don't have room for a bathroom here. Do you want to know how we solve that problem? We add one back here. There we go. You saw it here first. Build queen. Oh no. Okay. Oh, I can't wait for that in the comments. I've like done the build. There's no turning back now. It's over. All we can do is wait now for the ambush that is going to be, oh my God, you forgot a bathroom. Oh, my bad. It's my bad. Really like that. That's really pretty. The vampire rooms can get kind of spooky. I don't know. Kind of freaks me out sometimes. Forgotten Hollow kind of has those. Maybe some of these also. They also have a lot of the dead trees. So I'm gonna try and stick those somewhere. Maybe out on the balcony too. Ooh, like this. How can I get this in here without making it look really weird? Okay, there we go. Oh my gosh, I can't. Feel like there's also a lot of like rocks in Forgotten Hollow. So I'm gonna kind of try and like stick some around. Okay, I think we're good. I think we're done. Let me check this out here. We've got our eco lifestyle, really extra exterior here. Shipping containers with a graffiti on it, I feel like is kind of cool. Our little cauldron sticking out there in our backyard and our bathroom. When you go inside, you are in Willow Creek. We got the fountain, the chess table, Bob Pancakes is here. Got the candelabra for it, the goth family, and our purple trees, of course. Then we go across the hall and we're in Brightchester. Discover University coming in with the dining hall, the books everywhere, all the posters for the different houses. Then we go up and we're in our Strangerville bedroom, a little aspects here and there from every part of that world. The tires there, the plane wing, the huge shout out to the bar, our cozy little bed area over here. And then we go upstairs and we're in Glimmerbrook. Oh my God, some of these turned out way better than others, but we've got our portal here. We've got our little tribute to the trees. We have our little study area and our very cute little cozy couch area back there. Our cauldron on the outside, and then we go upstairs again and we are in Forgotten Hollow with our dead tree, our vines up the side, obviously our vampire esque bedroom happening here. And yeah, I think that's all I got for you guys today. Would love to try this again because obviously there's a lot of worlds left over, but let me know what you thought about this challenge and let me know any other build challenges you would like to see me do. This will be under the gallery under City Macaretta. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you in my next video. All right guys, that's it for today's video. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and leave any comments or suggestions you may have in the comment section down below. If you're looking for more build challenges to watch, I will link that playlist down below so you can binge those as well. And don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.